it's something I never use. And that I saw this as a chance before at that time. Really good chance. Nobody's using strobes outside. Let's go into that. And I started in the beginning. I got my first strobe. I still didn't know anything. I got a Canon flash. Really good Canon flash. Why I got the Canon flash? Because when I started photography, I was like, for Canon camera, probably you need to use Canon flash. Wrong. Very wrong. Yeah, it's not a bad flash. It's just an okay flash, but probably flash makers, strobe makers, they're gonna make much better strobes than the makers of the camera, because they're concentrated on that. They're concentrated on the strobes, and they will do something more different than just camera maker. So for me, the most important thing about the strobe is fire. If it fires, and you can use manual mode, that's it. So that's how I started. That's how I got my first flash. And doing something different that nobody else is doing. And the most beautiful things about using lighting is that, especially when using strobes, is that what you're gonna see, what is gonna be your result, nobody else can see that. Because it's not visible, it's just to you, it's an instant of a second. That's how I got into 135mm lens, like 6 years ago in Japan. Nobody was using 135. Really a few people was using it. Why is that? Because Japanese studios probably are very small. Maybe Hong Kong is a lot more. Very small, and even if you get 135, that kind of focal length, it's going to be difficult to use it in many situations. There it is, another chance for me to get something different. Yeah, probably in the first few months I was like, how should I do this? Yeah. But that made my expression. That made me different from the others. And same like the strobe. So yeah, more important than the camera is definitely your lens, what kind of expression you're gonna choose for your lenses. And probably in most of the cases, I don't go with a bunch of lenses for photoshoot. I usually bring 2 lenses, that's all. I will maybe bring 24 and 85, or I may bring wide, super wide angle and 135, or just 85, and that's all. Even for wedding photography, that's what I do. The other lens that I will use today, the zoom lens, Tamron lens, it's the first time I'm going to use it today. And many people in Japan are really excited about it now. And they wait for my impression about the lens. So I'm really excited to try it as well. And probably a zoom lens is also going to be very useful for wedding photography, for example, but in most of the cases, I would probably go with prime lenses because I like shooting at wide open aperture. So yeah, that's about the lens. And the next thing that is much more important even than the lens is your lighting. So no matter what kind of camera you use, no matter what kind of lens you're gonna choose, if you make a really good lighting, you're gonna take really good pictures. Because imagine you make the really good lighting. You make some amazing lighting, and when you make the lighting, maybe you change the lens, but you still get the great lighting. And maybe you're gonna change your camera. You may change your camera from the best expensive camera in the world, like a really good camera, 1DX, you change it to 70D. You're still gonna get the picture because you already made the good lighting. You have the good lighting. So one really important thing for me is to understand lighting, to see the lighting all the time. Everywhere I go, I'm usually sick about lighting. Everywhere I go, when I see a vending machine in Japan, I see the vending machine, I already imagine what white balance it has. That's how much I always see what light. When I'm on a date, for example, I might see what kind of light is coming on the face of
I was about to say the model.
So yeah, the lighting will really make your picture stand out. And it's really important. So, but there is another thing that, yeah, when you use lighting, for example, that's how I would usually shoot this situation. Probably that's how I would usually shoot this situation. I will talk about white balance and that stuff later, but it's just the white balance of the strobe. 5,600, 5,700 Kelvin white balance. I use only manual white balance. But it's just the light of the strobe. Nothing changed. You get this color of the sky. But, for example, in many situations, I will use color filters later when we shoot today, and I will talk about this more. I want to get this sky, not this color. I want to make it more blue, for example. I want to make this sky even more blue, more sad kind of looking sky. Then what I would do? Where do you go? Like this, right? Same situation, same time, same place. What I change is I put on the strobe orange filter, which turns, then I make my camera settings white balance to 3000, 5600, which changed my background to blue. I could also do another thing on this situation and change the color to even more red, kind of. Same time, same place, same situation. You can only do this because you're using lighting, because you're using strobes. So, and another thing to say from, I said earlier, do TTL know this? No. What is right or what is wrong? There is no right, there is no wrong. It's the way you see that situation. The way you want to connect this model to this background. It's your image, how you want to shoot this. Maybe this is right for you, but for somebody else, it's not right. Somebody else might want even warmer background. So, TTL can make great exposure, but it depends on you, how you see the situation and how you work on the situation. Don't face any Facebook messages right now. So, another thing is that lighting, you can only take this by lighting. You don't see it with your eyes, but there it is. And another thing is that, for example, this. There's another thing that's much more important even than your lighting. It's you, the one behind the camera. Because you have the great lighting, you have great camera, great lens. You can use light really good. But if you don't see the situation, then you wouldn't take the picture. If I didn't see this reflection, I wouldn't take this picture. It's you, how you see the situation, how you communicate with the model, how you see, what do you see is a beautiful thing. If I didn't see the situation, I just wouldn't do it. If I didn't see that reflection as well, I wouldn't shoot the picture. If I in this situation, it's raining very hard, but if I didn't think this is a beautiful situation to shoot, I wouldn't take this picture. So it's really the one behind the camera who can control what they take, who can make their picture look very interesting and make the one who is being taken picture be really excited and see something that really they don't see. And another thing to mention here, it's very important that I will try to support with this how much the camera is really not that important when taking pictures. That all the pictures that I was showing you right now, they are not taken with my 1DX. They are not taken with my 5D Mark II. They are not taken even with APS-C camera. All these pictures that I was showing, they're taken with my iPhone. It's all iPhone pictures here. All the pictures that I am showing right now, it's iPhone pictures. I'm using lighting with the iPhone. It's just iPhone picture. all taken with iPhone. That's how much the camera really doesn't matter. It's, and what I want to say with this is, get a good camera, get good lens, get good lighting. But don't be dependent on them. Don't be dependent on the great, for example, 85 millimeter lens, 1.8, which makes great bokeh. But that's all. Make that, but try to be above that and make something that's going to be even more interesting. Because here, with iPhone, even with iPhone, you can make the background a little bit darker. There are some apps in the iPhone that you can use manual settings. So you can make the background darker. And for example, also in the middle of the day with the iPhone. Even this one here, yeah, taken with the iPhone. I saw the beautiful reflection, but to be honest, there was no reflection there. Did you edit it? No, of course not. So what did I do? It's my iPad. I put my iPad below and I shoot with my iPhone. So it's you, how you see the situation. Everywhere you can find something really beautiful that can really make the difference. Taken with my iPhone, using my iPhone as a reflection. So how I do that? Do I do this? No. Do I do this? No. The iPhone camera is on the top, so in this situation, I want to make sure that the camera is as close to the surface as possible. So I put it down. Great reflection. Camera can make really interesting things. And 30 minutes passed already. Okay. So in a while we're gonna get shooting here, and we have a really interesting gray background. It's exciting. But we'll see what's gonna happen. And the other thing I wanted to talk before we go for photo shooting. Yeah, I said already, positive all the time. Whatever happens. Last week I went to Taiwan. Amazing. I arrived in Taiwan raining as hell. Amazing. First day pass, second day wake up in the morning raining as hell. Amazing. Third day raining, fourth day raining. I was in Taiwan for 4 or 5 days. Just before I got on the airplane to go back to Japan, beautiful sky. But it was raining from the beginning to almost the end. But I never got upset about that. I love it. And why? Because there are some pictures that can only be taken when it's raining. There are pictures that can only be taken in certain bad conditions. So I want to make sure that even the bad conditions, the rain or probably the minus 15 degrees snow. These bad conditions, I want to make them work for me. Whatever bad conditions I have, for example, what bad conditions can you have as a photographer? For example, yeah, rain that can break your camera maybe, or snow, or really dark condition when it gets dark so you don't see anything. Oh, give me that. I want that. Because when it gets darker, that means that you lose all the light. It means that now you can even use more of your lighting and make things that nobody else can see with their eyes. So whatever bad conditions, I want to make sure that they work for me. The same for the rain. And in Taiwan, like everybody upset about the rain. Oh, that's what I was waiting for. I don't want to show that I don't like the rain, for example. That's what I was waiting for. And yeah, we did a seminar in Taiwan in the rain. It was amazing. Everybody got very wet. But we got some really nice pictures. And yeah, for example, in the rain, just a couple of months ago in Japan, I was having a wedding photo shoot. And it was raining. It was cold, actually. Very, very cold and very much raining. And